I'm Virginia McGathey here at the floor of the CME Group reporting on the livestock market. Today, cattle was lower. It really is actually more of a mixed bag. It seemed that the rising supplies are really weighing on the futures right now, that even though the beef packing margins have been building and the U.S. beef and the cutouts has been pretty strong, it really is enough to get this market going. It's just very choppy and kind of moving sideways. Everyone's still worried about any retaliation, certainly from China, that, you know, it would might stall some of our exports and our demand for certainly the U.S. meat, and that's got everyone just a little bit nervous. Now, the feeders were also mixed. It seemed that, you know, the two-sided trade really stalled the futures. The beef exports were still kind of strong, but it still looks like that there is still some bigger supplies. The optimism is kind of waning a little bit, and there was also a big sharp drop in the non-commercial longs, and that was got everyone kind of a little bit nervous. And now, if they're starting to get out some of their long positions, does that make the market weaker? A little bit, but the fundamentals are still net long. So normally they can control the market and start to push us a little bit higher. We're still watching closely. Maybe the next couple of weeks it's going to be a little bit choppy trade. Hogs, on the other hand, have been easier again. Those physical hog prices are just sliding, and there hasn't been any way to kind of hold that up. Seasonally, this would be a time where the market would be an upturn, but we always have seen over the last year that electronic platform with the hog market, it definitely overshoots its objective. So now that we got to this point, will it dip a little bit lower? It has a possible chance to dip lower before it turns back around. But the trend is your friend in the hog market. As it moves lower, it's going to go until it finally gets that turnaround and it'll start to rally again. We expect that as we move closer and closer to the spring, we're going to get rolling. But maybe that might not come until mid-April. So we got the next couple of weeks that we're going to see really choppy trade in that hog market. So there's a lot to be said for volatility coming in the livestock sector. That's all from the floor at the CME Group here in Chicago. I'm Virginia McGathey.